mental wellness?
Yeah, this was something that happened recently because I lost my mom last year during the pandemic.
I'm so sorry to hear
and
that.
And that was, yeah, it was devastating. I mean, not only just losing my mom, whom I was very close to, but also, you know, during the pandemic, there was no funeral. There was no, very little closure.
Right.
And so for a while, I wasn't even able to enter my studio. It was just, I mean, there was absolutely no way.
Right.
And then I found that when I was able to enter again, my art was completely changing. So from being, you know, light and beautiful portraits or flowers, I was creating a lot of scribbling hard art with charcoal, really angry, really sad portraits and whatnot. And eventually it started to evolve to the collection that I recently completed that I just mentioned called Windows.
Mm-hmm.
And I realized that's because it focuses on our eyes being a window to our soul.
Mm-hmm.
And I couldn't really understand what the meaning was behind it, why I was creating what I was creating. But there's an art group that I belong to, and one of the things that they really encourage is understanding the psychology of what you're creating.
Ooh.
And by going through that process, I realized exactly why I was doing what I was doing, how it was all connected. And that's when I realized that it was really, you know, not only my mental health, but I realized at that point that I wanted to help others with theirs as well.
Well, that's really, wow. It's really great that you were channeling that energy that you had going on because it's so emotional and so expressive.
I think it's good that you defined the fact that artists do have a tendency, and it's not just people that paint, people that write, people that compose music. They channel a lot of their inner feelings. I think that's why they're so sensitive to being judged.
Yeah, and we know many of our listeners may be dealing with mental health issues right now. What advice can you give them?
I think first and foremost is that just for them to realize they're not alone. This past year has been difficult on so many people.
Oh, yeah.
Just the levels of isolation have been so, so difficult. So the first thing that I would say is find some sort of community that supports you. It doesn't matter if, you know, you're reaching out to friends and family, or if you even, you know, find just some sort of online group, anything, just so you can socialize in some way. The second thing I think is that, you know, we really need to be kind to ourselves right now because things are so difficult. It will get better, but this is where we are right now. And the last thing, and this is something that has helped me out a lot, is to make small goals. Quite often when I'm feeling bad, people will tell me things like, oh, just go for a walk, or, you know, just do something you like to do. And when you're in a really bad place, going for a walk is probably so off the chart. It's not going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
So start with really small goals. And that can be anything from just, I'm going to get out of bed today, or, you know, today I'm actually going to take a shower. And to people that are not, you know, that have not dealt with depression or, you know, other issues where they're feeling really bad, that sounds really silly. But to people that are in those really low, dark places, even doing those things are really difficult.
Little steps.
Baby steps. Absolutely. And then I think one of the best things you can do is to try something creative. And that's, you know, anything at all, because it really does help so much.
Oh, yeah. You know, creativity is not one size fits all, and neither is mental health. How can others use art to help them deal with their own mental issues? I think you are the poster child for understanding how art could be,
right.
How could impact it. But what would you say?
I would say find any kind of creative activity that you enjoy. And it absolutely does not have to be painting or drawing. It can be cooking. It can be dancing, singing, you know, playing an instrument, baking, writing, sewing. You know, there's so many possibilities. There are so many things that you can do, you know, to tap into that creative creative energy. Art is not going to take care of everything, but it definitely helps. You know, and they talk about all this science to back it up, you know, things like the cortisol. I don't even know if I'm saying that right, but I think it's the cortisol level.
It's cortisol for sure.
Oh, good. And raising your dopamine. And, you know, I'm really bad with that stuff because I have ADD and I'm really bad at science in general and math. But it's been proven that it helps so much. And, you know, it gives us an outlet, a way to express things that maybe we find really difficult to do verbally and to do without judgment. You know, just get it out of your system in one way or another.
There are a lot of things that you can do nutritionally. We always suggest that people research it thoroughly so they have a good understanding. And then they should always look to see if there's any potential side effects. Certain nutritional supplements are really helpful for a lot of people. I mean, we both, Angie and I, have used them and still are real cognizant of what we use nutritionally. But our advice is always check it, you know, check that.